drifting. It's funny cause they slipping. Me, I'm never missing. You can pick the heat, dog. I beat you with the Pistons. Listen, comprehend this and pay attention. Brutal Sims like LeBron. No one can defend.
What up? What up? It's your boy. You don't know Brutal Sim on the scene, Wicked and Mean, with a next video for y'all, man. So this video was actually requested multiple times by multiple subscribers, man, because y'all already see how quick I grind my player to a 90, man. I got there in like 3 days, to be quite honest. I took a few days off, but let's say like 3 days, rounded it out, and I got my player to a 90, man. And a bunch of people was asking me tips, bro. How do you get up there so fast, man? So this video is for you, man. Now, if this video does not apply to you, it's all good, man. Just like it and share it. It might help someone out, right? So I got a few tips right here, man. Now I got some offensive and defensive tips, man. So I actually put some pointers down to try to help you all out. So let's get straight to it. Now, the first thing on offense is always be mindful of your badges, man, all right, and play accordingly, because you already know, man, I'm playing with my point forward here, and this video is for point forward. I probably forgot to mention that. All right, so you already know I gotta get a bunch of assists, I gotta try and get a bunch of lobs, I gotta throw some flashy passes, I gotta get the break starters, and I gotta get the ankle breaker, man. Right now, what I like to do, man, right, is the next point. Always, all plays must begin with a pick and roll, bro. All right, now to call a pick and roll when you don't have the ability to call plays, all you got to do is tap LB real quick and the icon is gonna pop up, then tap the icon for the player you want to set the screens. Now, after calling for the screen, man, which leads me to my next point, is always keep your options open, because you gotta remember the badges you're going for, right? Especially with my pure points forward that I have right here, man. Of course, the pick and roll is a must, the dimer is a must, the lob city passer is a must, and the flashy passing is a must, man. You could even squeeze some teardroppers in there, to be quite honest, man, because you do have the teardropper badge at bronze, so you could actually do this and rack up some points as well. And so always keep your option open. Don't go in there saying I'm gotta get a lob. No, depending on the situation, you see I just did a flashy pass out to the wide open man right there, and there's the replay. You gotta keep your options open. And the good thing about this method is you attack all the badges at once, even the ankle breaker. Every time you call for a pick and roll and drive to the basket, once you pick up an assist or you score, it's gonna contribute to you getting the ankle breaker as well. So you are attacking all of these badges at once, man. This is so easy and so simple, man. So this is all I do on offense. Now for the defensive side of the game, man, right? Now, the first thing I want to put out there on defense, I always try to double team the ball handlers, right? Now, what I do when I go up to call a double team, especially when I really can call plays and set the team up on half court press, all I do is press the two L buttons, man. Now, this is gonna allow me to go in that strong defensive stance and hold down the L1 to actually call CPU for the double team as well. So it's gonna put pressure on the ball to actually try to force turnovers or shorten the possession, right? So you are sometimes gonna leave your guy open, but that's all right, man. You gotta give up these buckets to shorten these possessions, because shorten possessions means more chances for you to do your thing and rack up points. So that's why I always suggest to double the CPU at all times. Now, the next point I got here, man, is try to get defensive rebound if it's possible, man, all right? Try to get the defensive rebound if possible, because one of the badges you get for the point forward is that break starter badge. And to do that, I always try to get the defensive rebound. That's my first instinct. And you wait. After you get the defensive rebound, you wait till your teammates, the furthest teammate, reach the half line or is approaching the half line before you press L1, R1 to do the outlet pass to the closest player, the furthest player down the court. This is gonna get you the Break Starter badge, which is the last badge I will be going for, I must admit. I ain't gonna front to y'all, man, right? But I still was looking to try to get points towards this in every possession. Now, the next thing I got for y'all, man, right, which is my last point on defense. Now, whenever you contest a shot or you're just out of the play, to be quite honest, and there's no way for you to get that defensive rebound, always leak. Always leak, because one man fast break is one of those badges you get for this point forward as well. So this is a strategy I use defensively. These three, I always double team. I'm going over them. I always double team the ball handler, which is the CPU. Always double team it. I leave my dude open to shorten the possessions and try to force turnovers while I'm double teaming. The next thing is, I always try to get the defensive rebound. That's my first instinct. That's my first instinct. But it's a little difficult, of course, because sometimes, you know, the center is there. So I always try, right? But when I'm out of the play, whenever I'm completely out of the play, I leak and try to get the fast break so I could get some contribution to that one man fast break, man. So hopefully these tips help you out, man. You already know what the channel is about. A lot of y'all been requesting this, man, and I'm just trying to break it down to make it as easy as possible for y'all, man. So y'all already know how we do it, man. If you're first time to my channel, make sure and like the video, share the video, hit your boy subscribe, and if it's not your first time, like the video, share the video. You never know who's gonna help. Your boy Sing One Love Respect. Bless up. Now let me know if y'all want me to do a video showing y'all the quickest way to get these Hall of Fame badges. Right now I only got one more Hall of Fame badge to go for, which I'm grinding for right now. I think I got the best strategy, man, because I got these in less than a week, to be quite honest, because I really took a few days off. As I said, let me know what y'all think in the comments. Your boy Sim, if you're first time to my channel, like the video, share the video, hit your boy, subscribe. If it's not your first time, like the video, share the video. You never know who's gonna help. Your boy Sim, One Love Respect. Bless up.